In this video, I'm going to show you how to use Midjourney for logo design. Here are some of the examples of the logos I was able to create using Midjourney, and they are pretty good as a starting point, right? So here is a general structure of your prompt. We always start with slash imagine. Then I suggest you indicate the type of logo you want, like for example, mascot. You need the subject of your logo, for example, a robot, the style you want, then dash dash what to exclude, like no shading details. So we're gonna break down this video into five different talking points, starting with choosing the type of logo you want, right? So it could be a letter mark, or it could be a mascot logo, or it could be an emblem, or basically any type of illustrative logo. But as you can see here, Midjourney is not really good with text, so it's not good for watermarks. You know, logos that feature only a typeface without any illustrative, any kind of a symbol. Before we get started, I'm gonna show you how to set up your account. So you just click here, join the beta, continue to Discord, just sign up with your email. Once you are in, you will create your own server. That's the best way to work with Midjourney. That way you can keep everything private. You know, people always talk about going to the newbies room, but the problem with that is you have to constantly scroll because there's a lot of people using it. So it's better to create your own server. Now all you have to do is just click this little icon, go to Midjourney bot, add this to your server, and that's about it. Now we can go to our server and we can start creating. So starting with this letter mark, right? Type in imagine a letter mark of a letter A, logo, serif font, vector, and simple. Hit enter. Of course, the first time you use it, you're gonna have to accept the terms of service. And as you can see here, the image is being created. Of course, every time you run this prompt, you're gonna get a different result, right? So this one is pretty good as a monogram. This is not good as a logo, right? Because we didn't include dash dash no realistic details. So basically you can exclude. So if you copy the same prompt, but add dash dash no shading or realistic photo details, you add something like that, you're gonna see that the results are going to be much, much better. Just like something like this one on a white background. You can even say on a white background or separated on a white background. So as you can see here, the results are pretty good, right? The next thing we can try is we can create a mascot logo, right? So Midjourney is going to be good with anything but words. So let's type this again. Imagine instead of a letter mark, we're gonna do a mascot logo of a robot, no shading. So now the results are pretty different from what I got right here. This looks more like a logo. This looks more like an illustration. So we'd have to probably add more keywords, simplistic, minimalist, and so on. But let's move on. Another type of logo that you can create is an emblem, for example, like this one. So imagine an emblem for a motorcycle group, vector, simple, no photo realistic details. You can try with different keywords for different results, right? Okay, as you can see, the results are not as good as I got right here, but this one is pretty close. So, you know, you can upscale this image, you can create variations by clicking those buttons and so on. You can modify your prompt for better results. For now, let's move on. So the second tip I have for you is referring to artistic genres, right? Like psychedelic art. As you can see, we have those kind of melted vectors, shapes. For example, this style, this is more like a geometric, very simple flat design, and pop art, another great style to try. So let's try a couple of them, starting with a psychedelic art, right? So a logo for an ice cream brand, simple psychedelic art, no text, realistic details. So let's see how it's coming up, and I can already see that the results are pretty great. Maybe even better what I was able to achieve earlier. I really like those logos. We can now drag them to Illustrator, clean them up, vectorize them, and, you know, tweak them further. But maybe they are too detailed, but I really like this concept. So again, if you try this same prompt, but referring to a different style, like this style, for example, is going to give you a very different result. So using popular styles, genres, artistic styles is a great way of telling Midjourney how you imagine the ultimate outcome to be, in what type of style. You know, as you can see here, these are more geometric shapes, very flat design, rather than here more like cartoonish, pseudo 3D, melted shapes and stuff like that. Maybe these results are not that great as I was able to get right here. This is much, much better, but still, I just wanted to show you. And again, you can run the pop art for yourself. I'm not gonna run this because I just want to give you more tips. Another great tip is to describe the artistic technique. So for example, here I use a diamond shape to illustrate that, but we can, you know, a popular technique for logo design is just using one weight line, just like here. We can use a gradient just like here, or we can use a screen printing technique, which is gonna produce results just like that, right? So let's try a few of them here. Imagine a simple logo of a diamond line, flat, vector, and of course, no realistic photo details. Well, in this case, Midjourney didn't really listen. So we can try like outline, or you can try to like remove some of the other keywords, you know, like this is the closest probably, but it's still not just an outline. But let's try another technique, for example, with the gradient, so you can see how your logos can look much, much different just by prompting a different drawing technique, or just by prompting a different artistic technique. So again, I'm gonna copy this prompt, but I'm gonna change this for gradients. I'm gonna see what it does to my logos. Yeah, and these results are pretty good. This is better than what I was able to achieve, or even this one. So I can upscale, I can create versions and so on. But another trick is to refer to the famous designers. So for example, the most famous logo designer would be probably Paul Rand. This is what I was able to achieve by using this prompt, vector logo of a lion head minimal by Paul Rand. This is not a logo designer, but is a famous artist, Piet Mondrian. And these are the results. As you can see, Pablo Picasso, Cubism, very different results just by using names of famous designers. So let's try a few of them. Imagine a flat vector logo of a lion head, minimal, Paul Rand, no realistic photo. And these results are pretty great, especially the first one. I'll probably want to have it on white background, but I really like these curves. It's very simplistic, it's not overly detailed, so it could potentially work as a logo. And now the last tip I have for you, which we already been using, you know, tell the AI what not to do, tell Midjourney what not to do. Negative part of the prompt, what you don't want on your image. Hey, so that's it for today, and don't forget to check out my blog where you can see whatever I was talking about, all these examples, all these prompts, you can find it there. And by the way, I created this 50 plus styles for logo designs, a book of prompts. You can get it on my website for just $5. You know, I've basically run hundreds of different prompts and collected 50 best styles, you know, using the artists, the techniques and the genres, so you can see the examples and see the prompts behind them. So that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you do, then subscribe for more videos on logo design, brand strategy, and branding in general. This was Arek Dvorniczak from eBay Design. I will see you in the next video.